Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. President of the Suburna Jayanti Committee, Dr. Khandakar Mushraf Sen. My Secretary General, Mr. Mirza Alamgir, member of the Standing Committee, ladies and gentlemen, friends from the international community, my party colleagues, and most importantly, members of victims subject to enforced disappearance and extrajudicial killings who are participating in this afternoon program at Lakeshore in Dhaka. Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon to you all. Today, 10th of December, marks the UN designated International Human Rights Day. I take this opportunity to pay tribute to human rights activists and organization who work to make the world a better place for us. On this occasion, I recall all those citizens of Bangladesh who sacrificed their lives for establishing an independent Bangladesh with the hope of a free country where people's rights and will prevail, and establishing socio-economic emancipation and a future away from oppression. And I particularly take this opportunity to recall my party colleagues who gave their lives in fighting against the atrocities of an unelected authoritarian regime in the hope of restoring the rights of the people of Bangladesh for over a decade now. Dear friends and colleagues, it's with grave sadness I must state that 50 years on from our glorious liberation, the people of Bangladesh continues to seek freedom and the right to live a life free from state-sponsored repression. Sheikh Hasina's highly flawed government in Bangladesh continue to rule the country through influencing state institution to fulfill its political objectives through the application of brutal force on the people of our country. In today's Bangladesh, whether a person is a student or a lecturer or a farmer, a rickshaw puller, a teacher, banker, lawyer, or a doctor, it doesn't matter. You are all under siege from state terror, where daily lives and your future are made uncertain by an authoritarian regime trying to instill fear in every part of our society. Law enforcement authorities, the judicial system, businesses, people's rights are all at the mercy of a flawed government that rules by intimidation and terror, applying malign influence across public and private institutions. 50 years on, Bangladesh has been turned into one of the most corrupt countries in the world by the ruling regime, where a flawed government exists to only serve the purpose of one particular family and its political cronies. Dear friends and colleagues, the people of Bangladesh believes that Bangladesh is not for sale and neither it is a family business. Our country has been liberated in 1971 to give ownership to the people of our country and it belongs to all of us, not to any particular family. It is the duty of every one of us, to protect our country's sovereignty, safeguard its security, and ensure people's rights prevail over any so-called political class or a few corrupt elites in an authoritarian regime. The Bangladesh National Party, when it returns to government again, inshallah, will give the country back to the people. And that's why I say we must take back Bangladesh, as we don't recognize the country's dire state of our country, current dire state of our country, as we aspire and desire, hope to see it. Dear colleagues and friends, every year on this day, we hear distress and grief pain families of those subject to extrajudicial killings and disappearance go through every day in the hope that they will hear the news of their loved one returning one day, or in the hope they will see justice for those who have been killed at the violent hands of the state. Their calls for justice continue to be miscarried by the state. Inshallah, one day soon, in a future government elected by the people, will ensure justice for all those families that have suffered. I'm grateful to the Department of Human Rights of Bangladesh Nationalist Party for this timely publication, highlighting systematic violation of rights under state influence in the country, which has destroyed the country's electoral process and system. I hope friends in the international community will find some factual basis in this substantive documentation to further the work of restoring people's right in Bangladesh again. Friends in the international community, one thing I would like to state here today is that the people's confidence in the process of a free, fair election in our country is non-existent, as they don't trust the current Sheikh Hasina's regime to hold any free, fair election at any level in the country. The democratic process does not exist anywhere in the country anymore in the country. It has to be restored, and we must realize that there's only one platform that can bring about changes, and that is more powerful than anything, and that is the people's collective will and unity to restore their rights. That is the movement the BNP aspire to lead, with the support of the people from all walks of life in our country, to restore democracy in Bangladesh. Dear friends, if you please allow me, I would like to briefly say a few words in regards to Begum Khaleda Zia, the nation's opposition leader and the first woman to be elected as prime minister by the people of Bangladesh, who has dedicated her life to public service. She has championed girls' education, rural and agriculture development for the betterment of the people of her country, but today is critically ill. The flawed regime continue to deny her rights as a citizen to advance medical treatment abroad. When in office, governments make some mistakes, but in no way did Begum Khaleda Zia ever compromise the rights of the people of Bangladesh or the country. Her political determination was always firmly embedded amongst the people of Bangladesh and promoting Bangladesh to the world as a place of great hope and potential. I would like to take this opportunity to seek your prayers for her recovery and good health. In today's world, government must do more to reach out to every sphere of society. It must do more to be inclusive and representative, and it shall also legislate to encourage freedom and liberties. All political leaders must exercise foresight to deal with complex problems and must be free from the desire of personal ambition alone. The root cause of the sharp demise of human rights in Bangladesh resides in the breakdown of the electoral process, committed with intent by the state to establish its one-party rule. Dear colleagues, dear friends, as I always say, together we must raise our voices nationally and internationally to restore the democratic process and human rights in Bangladesh. Through our collective efforts, we shall succeed, inshallah. Thank you again for taking the time to attend this event, and I wish you all very well. Assalamu alaikum.